job site trailer, the construction site office, has now become more of like an air traffic control center. It's more sort of where people are making sure that information in the cloud and digitally is being provided to the right people at the right time when they need it. People used to have to physically go into the job trailer to get the drawings or go to the drawing rack or something like that, whereas now literally it's all in the cloud.
There is a ton of coordination going on. There's things coming in from every direction. They're managing the logistics of all of those deliveries. They're organizing information so that it can be absorbed, you know, processed by the people on site. That environment used to be physical. And these days it's creating that virtual environment, that virtual experience where people can find the information they're looking for.
There was a risk when you had to travel some sort of physical distance away from the job trailer and you maybe were there for the day. Sometimes the pace of change on some of these big projects where information is changing very quickly or things get updated and adapted, that wouldn't feed through to people in locations that were physically distant from the job trailer. Whereas now it's instant. You know, when stuff gets uploaded or changed, everyone's got the right information at the right, in the right place at the right time.
That's always been one of the most challenging, you know, pieces in our industry, is making sure that everyone is working off of the same information. And you know, we used to physically spend time going and checking on people and making sure that they were, you know, on the latest version, that they were building off of the properly dated drawing. And there was even a time when we printed those on different colored, you know, sheets of paper so that you could spot the pink paper from across the job site. But these days you have systems that can track, you know, who's opening the documents, who's read them, who's added, you know, their comments. And that allows you to really understand, you know, who's interacting with the data that you're distributing and sending out to the project. Within the last, you know, few years, you know, things like drone imagery, you know, 360 imagery, you know, site video cameras, they're all giving us, you know, that better sense of what's going on the project. And these days it is more important than ever to be able to communicate with the owner about what's happening, you know, on their project, to catch errors, you know, before they become, you know, larger problems. I remember in the past working with an owner out of New York, and they were able to walk the job site virtually every week with 360 imagery, and they pointed out one of the walls that was painted the wrong color. You know, really simple, easy mistake, and very quick to fix. But if we had waited for them to come in town, you know, all the time that would have transpired, that time is so crucial to our project teams to kind of shorten that gap.
What all of this hangs upon is good IT systems and infrastructure. So whether actually on the physical job site, you know, good mobile data networks, people can actually stay connected, or now with people working from offices in different parts of the world and working from home, people's local bandwidth matters.
IT has become an ever more important part of our industry's, you know, toolkit. Bandwidth and connectivity has really become that crucial linchpin to all of the operations, you know, for a construction company. You know, I've also often said how as technology becomes a bigger and more important part of the operations of an AEC firm, it's more important than ever that they have, you know, people staffed that know how to, you know, manipulate and leverage that technology to enable their workforce to get their job done.
I guess one of the other big changes that's come about really with the pandemic and with the lockdowns and the restrictions on people's movements and the introduction of social distancing is that lack of physical interaction. So, you know, a lot of the industry runs on face-to-face interaction, on conversations, on people debating things, discussing things, arguing about things in some instances. It's almost like digital collaboration, it has its benefits. It helps massively in terms of efficiency, you know, avoiding rework, helping find the right information at the right time. But ultimately, it's not about replacing teams or replacing people. It's just about better enabling those people to do their jobs more effectively, more efficiently, in a more collaborative manner, ultimately.
And I very much think that human interaction, that ability to bounce ideas and thoughts off of one another, is really crucial, you know, to the work that we do in our industry. The bar for technology and you know, digital adoption doesn't have to be so high.
This doesn't necessarily have to be expensive or complicated. I think the beauty of, you know, tools like Bluebeam and other platforms like it is it's incredibly intuitive to use, and it is at a level that it actually seeks to democratize information and democratize technology to the whole of the industry. It's not ultra complicated and expensive design authoring software that you have to have hours of training to use. It can literally be picked up on a tablet, on a smartphone, wherever you are in the world, and you can get going straight away.